So how do you really avoid emails going to the spam folder? Well, in this video, I'm going to share with you five practical things you could do right now to ensure that your emails are actually reaching their inbox. Let's get into it. All right, so the first thing we want to do is we want to make sure that we are not on any blacklist, right? Meaning the domain that you're sending from, whether you're using like a third party such as like GetResponse, AWeber, or you're using your own, you want to make sure that you're not on a blacklist, because if you are, then 9 times out of 10, your emails are going to be going to the spam folder, right? So I'm about to show you a tool you could use to be able to check that. All right, so now what we want to do is we want to go over to this website right here called mxtoolbox.com, and then once you get here, it's gonna look pretty much like this. And then I want you to go ahead and click on blacklist, all right? All right, so now what I want you to do is in this box, I want you to go ahead and type your domain that you're actually using to send your emails, all right? So I'm gonna just go ahead and use one of my domains, rakeemaddison.com, and then I'm gonna hit blacklist check. Now what this is doing is this is actually going through and figuring out, am I on any blacklist when it comes to email marketing, all right? So now let's take a look. So you can see right here, I don't have any, my domain isn't on any blacklist at all. And then as we continue to go down, everything is saying okay. So that means that we're good to go. So my domain doesn't have any problems. Hopefully yours is, you know, looking as good as this one. And then of course you can also, let's go ahead and click back on blacklist. You can actually type the IP of where you're actually sending from. So as I was talking about earlier, like with GetResponse, ActiveCampaign, and all of those, they also have IPs that they send from, whether that's going to be like a shared IP, or you can actually go out and purchase yourself like a dedicated IP, which would be more along the lines of just your own personal thing, all right? All right, so the next thing we want to do is we want to verify the sender domain, right? So the same domain you just verified to see if it was on a blacklist or not. And if it wasn't, then that's good. But of course, if you are on a blacklist, one thing I would recommend is that you either get a new domain or you take the time. And it's going to take a considerable amount of time for you to get off that blacklist, or you can reach out to the company or whatever. But if you verify that your domain wasn't on the blacklist, then what you want to do next is you want to verify the sender domain. So the sender domain was Rakeem Addison, from what I showed you earlier, right? Now I'm on that domain inside of GoDaddy. Now inside of GoDaddy, you can see that I have, you know, a lot of stuff as far as like the behind the scenes of my domain. So if you see right here, I got this CNAME right here, this one right here, and this one right here. So what these are coming from are one of the email marketing softwares that I'm using. So whatever email marketing software you're using, they're going to have a way for you to verify your sender domain. And typically, that's going to be what we call like a process called SPF and DKIM, right? Those are email authentication methods. So those are actually going to prevent like a hacker hacking into your email, changing things in your email, and then now it's still sending over to whoever you were sending it to, like, you know, inside of like your newsletter or whatever it is. And if they hack into that, that could really affect your reputation, because now you didn't even know it because you didn't have a SPF or DKIM set up to basically say, hey, it's actually coming from me and nobody can intercept into that process. Hopefully that part right there makes sense. If it doesn't, let me know down below. All right, so let me go over here to one of the softwares that I use. So inside of this software, well, as you can see, I'm inside of the mailing settings. You can see right here, it says rakeemaddison.com verified, right? So if I come right here, it says set up domain authentication to improve your email deliverability. So what I did is I hit setup and then I put my domain name inside of here. Now, when I did this, they're going to give me certain settings, right? So let me show you what those settings look like. So you see this right here, it says DNS record type, CNAME, CNAME, CNAME. Now, if you remember over here, I have CNAME, CNAME, CNAME. So all I literally did was put in the information that they wanted me to put in. Once I put that in, I set my stuff up. And so now I'm leveraging my domain and the emails are actually being sent from my domain, right? So going back to what I was talking about with the security, preventing like hackers from hacking into your emails that go out and so on and so on. That's why this part is very, very important. All right, so the next thing you want to do is you want to validate your email list. So essentially all this is where you're cleaning your list of like invalid and fake emails. Because we know sometimes when people come to pages, they may really, really want to figure out what's on the other side of the page, or they want to get the lead magnet without you, you know, continuously sending them emails. So they're literally just typing in anything. And so now guess what? That's actually going to hurt your sender reputation score. And if you know anything about the sender reputation score, it's essentially like a credit score, but for sending emails. So the lower that goes, the more times you're going to end up in the spam box. And I'm sure that's not what you want. So I'm going to show you a tool that I use personally to actually validate my emails. And I do it more on like a 30-day basis. You can either do 60 days or 90 days. And as you continue to do this, now when you're sending out your emails, you're not sending it to fake emails or invalid emails, and your sender reputation score stays level. So now if we go over here to zero bounce, what they can do is you can do like a single email validator. Now, obviously that's gonna take you a lot more time, or you can actually upload a file, right? So if I click upload a file, as you can see, this is the page that we're on. Now, I'm not going to upload a file for sake of actually exposing my email list, right? I don't want to show other people's emails, but you can easily just go ahead and hit drag a file, right? Take the file over here, right? As you obviously, you can see I got my contact list. I'm not going to actually upload that in here, but if I do, it'll literally go upload into that list, and then I'll be able to it'll like give me like another CSV that shows, okay, all of these emails are fake. Right. So I could actually go ahead and get rid of those emails and then re-upload into my platform, or just remove the ones without having to re-upload. Right. Very, very simple process. Now, another way that we could do it is, and I'm going to show you how to do this one, single email validator. Right. So let's say, for instance, I'm going to go ahead and just type a fake email in real quick. 4567 RGY2. I'm almost certain that that's not an email. Now, if it is, we got some crazy stuff going on, all right? All right, so let's see. All right, so that shouldn't be an email. I'm gonna show you what it looks like. So you see how it says status invalid, right? So that's an invalid email. It let me know that. So there's a lot of power in that, because now I won't be hurting my reputation score, which is very, very important when it comes to email marketing. All right, so the next thing you could do is you could leverage a strategy called a double opt-in strategy. Now, the way that works is a person has to verify more than once that they actually want to be on your list, right? So let me show you how to do this inside of GetResponse. So in GetResponse, if I come up here and I click on list, and I'm gonna just go to any one of the random lists that I have in here, and I want to mouse over these three dots right here. And don't worry, most email marketing platforms out there, they allow you to do this. If they don't, you know, you may want to look for another one if that's a strategy that you want to, you know, go forth and use. Now, if I click here and then I come over here to where it says settings, I click on settings, and then I go to subscription right here. Now, it's very, very simple for me to turn this on inside of GetResponse. All I got to do is just literally click this on and click this on right here, and now I have double opt-in. So now they're asking for permission to be on your list. That's where the power is. So now when you send emails, since they confirmed twice that they really wanted to be on your list, it's going to ensure that you actually make it inside of their inbox. Now, another strategy you can apply, and this is more of a manual strategy that I do personally myself, is within your first autoresponder email that they receive from you, like from your lead magnet or whatever it is, you could actually try something like this, right? So you can see in this email, I say, hey, it's Raheem Madison. I'll tell you a little bit more about my story later, but for now, I just want to take a second to say hello and help you get started. And then I say, here's how to get started and get the most from me. Please whitelist my emails. Otherwise, my emails may not get through, right? And if they're really wanting this information, they're going to want those emails to come through. So I tell them, I say, if you use Gmail, just drag this email over to the primary tab and drop it there. So I just told them how they could do it. So all they got to do is drag that email right over to primary, and that's going to ensure that they're consistently receiving my emails, which is exactly what they wanted in the first place. All right, so the next thing you could do is avoid spam trigger words, right? So with the spam filters, they're looking for certain words inside of your emails, because it actually looks at your subject line. It also looks at the entire email to sniff out these words. And when they find these words, they almost instantly send your stuff to the spam folder, which is something that you don't want, right? So here's an example of all the different words, right? So we got number one, Act now, affordable, apply now, money signs, 100%. Another one is like 100% guaranteed, right? Just over promising a lot in your emails. Additional income, be amazed, your own boss, billion, buy cash. Certified, congratulations, double your incoming cash. So a lot of these words that you're seeing right here are commonly known spam words. Most of the emails that have a lot of these words in there, they end in the spam. And one thing to keep in mind is just how you're using it. Like if you're doing like a whole lot of over promising, and we know this is pretty common when it comes to like the internet marketing space, there's a whole bunch of over promising. And honestly, when I look at my email, a lot of times I study like what are they saying, and then I go and look at my stuff in my spam box, and that's another little strategy for you. Go ahead and look in your spam box, look at what they're saying, and avoid using those type of words because they're landing in the spam box, which means they're not reaching you, and you don't want to be like them, not reaching the people who you're trying to reach. So hopefully you got some value from this video, and if you did, definitely go ahead and give me a thumbs up. Also, drop me a comment down below letting me know any additional questions that you have. And with that being said, I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Peace.